tumbling, walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down.
Hello, I'm David Elkind. I've been studying children and adolescents in classrooms like this one since the early 1960s. Over the years, I've observed how children and adolescents always mirror, to a certain extent, the social and cultural environment in which they grow up. It is these underlying commonalities that we will highlight in this video, using the work of Barbel Inhelder, Jean Piaget, Erikson, Erving Goffman, and my own research. Piaget and Inhelder labeled this level of thinking formal reasoning and identified several components of it that we will take up in turn. After about the age of 12 or 13, most young people can use abstractions, that is, use symbols for other symbols. They can also reason about propositions, regardless of their factual truth or falsity. Adolescents can now imagine possibilities which enable them to create ideals. In addition, they can begin to think about thinking.
Okay, Namaka, can you tell me what the proverb, "Don't change horses in midstream," means?
It can get really hectic because they could start jumping around and then they'd want to drink some water while you're trying to clean it or something.
Okay. Namaka is now 14 and well-established in formal operational reasoning. You shouldn't change horses in midstream.
Oh, when I hear this, I usually think of, like, when something's going wrong, you shouldn't switch over to, like, something else. Like, if you're in a crisis, you shouldn't switch your leaders. You should tend to stick with what you're doing in the first place.
Abstractions makes it possible for adolescents to meaningfully talk about big issues, such as pollution.
Fertilizer, right?
Mudslide.
Anybody see anything happening?
Propositional, or if-then, thinking.
Models. We put them
center. These students in an eighth grade drama class are planning the transitions between acts in an upcoming talent show.
Danny, you're such a good actor. You're so funny. You're this, you're that.
Okay, Danny, theater productions are teamwork.
To entertain the possibility of perfect people, places, and things, adolescents, for example, can conceive of a world in which there is no poverty, no crime, no war, and in which all of the natural environment is protected. Children don't reflect on their own thought processes nor appreciate their privacy. All that changes with the attainment of formal operations. Now, for the first time, young people can reflect on their own thinking. They begin to use phrases like, I think, I believe, and I doubt. Combinatorial thinking is the final aspect of formal reasoning we are exploring. Combinatorial logic enables the young person to keep a number of variables in mind at the same time. In this case, weighing the results of several tests on different measures to decide which offers the best value. Construction of a sense of personal identity involves social, emotional, and intellectual integrations. As we saw in the interviews with Laura, even a young person plays many roles in the world. The construction of a sense of personal identity requires the combinatorial and propositional thinking made possible by formal operations.